morning, guys. So we're gonna get started today, and the first thing I've got to do is get this candle out of the molds from last night. I'm thinking they turned out really well because everything went smooth. So let's go see what they look like.
Pop out here and see how things were going. My hot tub is now flashing BO2. So apparently something's going on. So I'm gonna go ahead and look that up and see what's up with that. But everything else looks beautiful out here. Bruce came out to fix the hot tub. So we're hoping this will be the right answer. There's definitely plenty of YouTube videos if it's not.
It's not a YouTube video. It is the University of YouTube. That's where I go to college.
There you go.
All right, guys, so let's see what we have here. Save all of that beeswax because it's so valuable. Go ahead and cut this bottom piece. Save all my wick pieces. Okay, and that one's not too long. As I remember, I make dryer, not dryer. Look at that. Ta-da! Make, fire starters with the dryer sheets. I mean, not dryer sheets, lint. If we still have a lot. And occasionally we do use it, so but mostly it's only if we have to. All right, so that's that one, and that one is the it's the 6-inch hex cylinder. Okay, the pumpkin I have to have help taking out, so that isn't something I can do on my own. He has to help me with that. But at least somebody. Okay. Cut the bottom of this. And this won't need to be this long. And this is the 60 ply on wick. It's a little bit thicker, and it's okay. So this one, the trick to this one is to open it up, pretty strong too, and pull back because of his face. Okay, so now what I want to do is go ahead and melt down the bottoms just a little tiny bit so that they sit exactly even, because as you can see there's a little bit of a bumpiness to it right there, and that's just from the top where the wax was. And go ahead and sit that down. So all I use, which I have this in that video if you want to watch it, it's just one of these old griddles, and I've been using this one for a really long time to melt the bottoms of the wax. So all right, guys, So that's it. And for the candles, I'm gonna go ahead and get these packed up and shipped out today. And I know that they will be very happy to get their candles because both of these are repeat customers. And thank you, thank you, thank you.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna show you my rock tumbler here. We're gonna go ahead and take this in here in the other room and go see how these little rocks have turned out. Okay. Alright guys, so let me go ahead and set that up.
Okay. Looks like to me I'm gonna get to get these rocks off. This was the third stage. Okay, so like every single time it's really hard and a little water over it. Okay. Oh. Got one more stage after this, but okay, these rocks literally, this was a driveway rock. Look. Look at this beautiful amethyst. Is that not the coolest? Now it runs for a long time. And if you want to start rock tumbling or anything like that, go to Michigan Rocks. That's who I went to. We already had all this stuff. And my boys had done it back with a toy kit they had. And once I tried to use that, it like the motor was already burnt up in it. So I already had tumblers from jewelry making. So I was like, well, let me go ahead and do this. And now I am, I'm hooked. And it's not like, you know, I have to have it or anything like that. And it's just basically for fun. Look at this one. I mean, isn't that beautiful? Driveway rock. I mean, I'm just still blown away with that. And so will the boys when they see them. This pretty blue one. Another driveway rock. Let's see. This is, I guess, an onyx. Wow. Look at that. I could do some wire wrapping on these and make some necklaces. But it's like when Bruce always brings me home something, he's like, oh, I thought you could use this. And it'd be cardboard or any kind of thing, wood, piece of wood. I'm like, yeah, in my next life. Because, you know, it's like not much time left, as you can see. Look at that. So pretty. All right, guys, now that I'm gonna go ahead and set up the fourth stage and get started on the next stage. And we'll be at the final stage. And I don't know, in case you didn't see it in my candle making one, these are the ones last time that I did. And look, is that not gorgeous? Look at that. And this one here, the heart shaped amethyst. I hope you can see that good. Rose quartz. Okay, guys, so I'm back in here now. It's aluminum oxide polish. This is the last stage. So it gets 3 tablespoons of this, and it is so sealed that and yet it's got so many. There we go. Go ahead and open it enough so I can get in there and get this dedicated one tablespoon. And so it gets 3 tablespoons of this stage, and it runs for 2 more weeks. Get that one sealed up. And you always want to make sure there's water on this right here so it goes into the groove really easy. There we go. All sealed up. Put the top on. The washer. And I'm going to go ahead and mark my calendar. For 2 more weeks. I'm gonna be cooking on the Blackstone again this morning. The thing is, I am having a lot of trouble getting my videos up. So apparently it started number 3. Okay. So, I don't know, we'll see how it goes today, but what I'm gonna be cooking, it's kind of like a brunch, more so. I've got some chicken, it's our chicken that I have cut up into smaller pieces, and I will be using the everyday, phone call. Where was I? All right, so I was telling you that I'm using this. This is the guy from my market, and it's Tony. So this stuff is wonderful, so check him out. And I'm gonna be cooking some eggs and also some eggplant and warming up some of the ribs from last night. Plus, I'm gonna roast some corn. Okay guys, so let me get this done. Dusty's coming back from checking things out on the farm.
Okay, so what I did was I put some bacon grease on. Let's see how it's doing. Look at that.
Look at the corn. And those are some eggplant. Now, I don't know how they're going to do, but I'm going to give it a go. Just to see. Darkened up.
I'm back in now. Everything is cooked. Look how pretty yummy. I don't know what you would say. Delicious. The chicken turned out.
Incredible.
The corn. The eggplant.
And where'd you get that chicken from?
from you,
from us,
viruses,
and Dusty.
And Dusty.
Yeah. Yeah, Dusty has a lot of.
A lot of work in that chicken too.
Yeah, I got a lot of work in everything.
Yes, you do, Bradley.
Yep, it's treat time. All right, sit. Everybody sit. Sit. It's Julianne, sit. Excuse me, Sophia.
Ow!
Sophia just can't control herself.
I actually jumped.
I don't have.
Oh, Jesus.
I didn't even get all that.
Of course, she jumped harder than my grandma. Actually, I don't know if you can get some. Like, break it in. Good job.
Wait, Sophia's like, I'm back. I'm back. All right, Julie's back.
Julie, you're back already.
Woo!
Bruh.
Julie can jump, can't she?
She got a hops.
And Molly can too.
Yeah, Molly, good job, Molly.
Yeah.
You can jump so high.
Sophia.
No more. All gone.
All done. Yum.
Okay, guys. So this is an addition of what was picked this morning. A little bit over here. And more zucchini squash. Got more eggplant down there, of course. And, of course, now it's cooked on the Blackstone. It's absolutely busting, as Dusty says.
You're so strong.
Uh-oh.
Okay, guys, so I got the boss man up to help me with this so you can see how this pumpkin is. Ta-da! A kiss.
One kiss for payment.
Sharpening the blades?
Yes, ma'am. Sharpen the blades. Save my boss some money.
Oh my gosh. Stop.
You just gotta do it. You can get about 4 good sharpenings out of them, then you gotta replace them. But trust me, John Deere does not give them away. You really bought this princess.
No.
Do that and work on the B bar there. I had already had it up here, so I can go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. Not yet. It's still working. It's only been 15 hours working on this video to get up to the internet. Wow. Alright, guys, so we're getting ready to put these in the freeze dryer, finally. So we've got 5 trays of the large. I'm gonna load it up now. We just finished rinsing the pickles, we've got a few more left to go. Bruce does all that heavy work.
I accept volunteers.
And now all the trays are now loaded for the freeze dryer. So as you can see, we do a lot of peppers, and I do have a video where we did the Marconis last year, which they were absolutely delicious. We ate them all winter long with our hummus, because we love hummus. And these are the jalapenos right here, and then the rest of them are the Marconis and the freeze dried. Jeez, here we go again. The banana peppers and the blots. Always gotta be a fly get in when you open the door.
Yep.
That's
welcome to the South.
All right, guys. So I'm gonna take the last tray over to the freeze dryer. And look at that. Look how beautiful they all are in there.
Put your filling in.
That is always the hardest part for me to remember for some reason. Okay. There we go. And Bruce has already closed the valve for me, because y'all know me, I would forget. Start. And it's not frozen. And it's in here. There we go, freezing. All right, we'll let you know how this turns out. They're getting angry. Buzzing like that. Oh yeah, I gotta go now. I don't have a suit on or anything. And for some reason they like me. They like to bite me or sting me, should I say. It's absolutely beautiful. The chickens are like, hey, you got anything for me? Hey guys. All right guys, so I'm gonna make a little dessert for tonight. I know Bruce won't be able to resist, but it's a simple, easy little thing. This is some of my jam that I made. And I just lay it out. Looks like to me I'm not gonna have enough to since I had more. I thought it was more in that jar than there was. So all I do now is just take them and put them together. And these are just those little crescent rolls, the crescent roll sheet. Sometimes I do the center, but it's an easy little treat. Big one. And then cook them at 375. And we'll see how they look when they're done. Alright guys, look at this. They're already done. It was like magic. It really was. It was so fast. I'm getting done already anyway, so I just put on some butter, and I'm also going to be using this butter for the buns tonight. And then sprinkle it with a little bit of powdered sugar. And you got a nice little easy dessert, quick and easy. And then I'll go ahead and let this cool, and that's it. And I'm gonna cook dinner, but I'm really tired and I still got 9 double batches of pickles to do tonight. So it's gonna be a quick dinner. All right guys, so now I'm gonna cook some these are bison bratwursts that we got at the farmer's market. It's from Burroughs Land Farms, so we'll be having that tonight. Hey.
Very beautiful.
You just came in, and he's hot and sweaty. He's gonna get a shower, so we can.
Go to pickle prison.
Yeah, go to pickle prison. So.
I'm working in beehive prison.
Oh yeah, how's the bees doing?
Stinging. They don't like the bee guy.
Oh.
Getting their boxes ready.
So. Everything's looking good on the grill. I made you a little treat.
Look at that.
Wait till you see what you got inside.
I can't wait.
The timer's about ready to go off for the last rinsing. And I'm gonna toast the buns. And I'm really tired, so 8, 9 double batches. Are you feeling it?
I'm feeling it. The scary part is I'm going to go do 9 double batches tonight, but they're already sold.
Not quite.
Yeah. On Sunday, they'll be gone.
Guys, look at those buns. And those yummy bratwurst. Look at those. Look how good they look. Blackstone.
Oh my God. Why didn't you tell me about the elk that are in there?
Oh, Dusty's already dipped into it.
Oh, it's so good.
Oh. And it's so simple. And it literally took no time.
We need a gluten-free model.
I know, right?
Really good.
Always want to make sure your temperature is at least above 165. Guys, I'm gonna call it a night. We gotta go over here and do these pickles, and both of us are tired. So I'll catch you tomorrow, and I'll let you know how long the freeze dryer takes if it's done tomorrow.